Okay, hi guys, so welcome back to another episode of Jahan Fishing. The time now is about 8 plus 9, yeah, something like that. Okay, basically at night we are at Punggol waterfront. So recently we've been hearing from our friends that now is Duri or Jahan season. So basically Duri is the small marine catfish. When they grow big we call them Jahan. Yep, so they said the Bedok Jetty, Labrador, Punggol, all these kind of places have huge Jahan and in good numbers. So here we are at Punggol because it's slightly more accessible than other places. So we'll probably be here until maybe 12 or 1. Yeah, quite tired lah. We won't cover many hours today. So yeah, the target is big Jahan. The bait is Kerong Sotong. So we'll try our best. Hopefully we'll get to hunt our target lah. Yeah, so we'll update you guys later. Something, you know what? Eh? Yeah, no. Duri, Duri. Ikan Duri. Hey, hold the phone. Small Duri, finally, Chong. First Ikan Duri in all our videos.
Actually our target species is a big Duri.
Big Jahan.
Yeah, Jahan. Slowly.
Okay, bye bye. Oh no, it's a bit dark. Can roll a leaf? Oh baby. Mangrove with tail.
What the
hell? It's white spot.
White spot.
Yeah. I don't know.
Hold this. I thought it would be something. Yep, it's a toss.
Usat.
Yeah, usat. I was wondering why the rock fell. Jahan, this one. Oh shit, you got on my line also.
Got on all the line, this one also got on. But it's quite near.
Oh, we need. I think you got on. Oh, it's a Jahan. Garfo? Okay, finally, after repeated attempt to graph it,
look at this.
In the end, we just
right at the lip. Eh.
Yeah, we just put
so
our hand.
So damn close. Eh.
Our hand was like, wow, really tall, really where quite screwed because wow. The line we pull it out with our hands. Wow, painful, man.
I think we need to get
yeah,
a
better see
graph.
Our
where's our graph? Ah?
Our graph is I don't know. The this four rods of lines are.
The graph is there. It's
I don't know,
the,
man.
Yeah,
okay, we'll find a way.
Look at that.
Yeah, look, let me show
this. What the heck? Oh, it's gone. Yeah, this is gone.
We'll find a way.
Anyway, wow, okay.
Yeah, anyway, just now we were saying we were target
fish
is Jahan.
Yeah, Jahan.
Managed to get a
Jahan.
Good size.
Jahan. Oh, he's still damn angry. No? We got your boca. No? This time we sort out later.
Anyway, we will. We will bleed and eat
it.
Anyway,
we guff right here. Jahan.
Yeah, fun lah, fun. Jahan. Fun fish. At least we got our target.
Good fight lah.
Yeah, bleeding like.
Okay.
It's quite a lot of blood.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Hanging in the water lah.
Hanging in the water. Can actually got the... But the rope from the gaff can track them too. But must track the lead. I think the one.
This one quite a lot of blood.
Yeah, this one really quite a lot. But later we pour sea water in.
Time to retire leader.
Alright, so many FG not to retire. What the shit. Yeah, anyway, yeah, this is a leader lah. So for those people who don't tie leader or don't know, basically we connect braid to a monofilament lah. For people who don't, okay, for people who don't fish, braided line is strong. Like you can pull, but you cannot. What is more?
Absorb shock.
More. Yeah. You cannot rub on a rock. Like
abrasion.
You, yeah, it's not abrasion resistant. Whereas this monoline is more abrasion resistant, but you can't really pull it.
This one is fluorocarbon.
Fluorocarbon. Yeah. So.
Deep on,
The way we connect this so that the fluorocarbon will absorb the shock of any rock, any. Nonsense in the water lah, so that your braider line will not snap. Yeah, so this knot is called an FG knot. Most of the anglers will know lah, this one.
Broke.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, very big tick, very strong tick. Not sure you all heard the drag, but yeah, my power cool down most likely.
Yeah, clean.
Yeah, none power cool down, hope you.
What the? Wire.
Shack. Something hard took my this rod. Yeah, and my other rod is in the freaking water. Yes. Something, there's another Jahan on this. Yeah, so quite messed up because I have a fish here and something, a fish took my rod and it's in the water. So a bit messy, but okay. We are trying to get back my rod, but I think cannot, it's a bit far. So we managed to get our second Jahan. Okay, that was really that was really messy because I just lost my rod, yeah. A Daiwa surf cast rod.
Look at the rod stand.
Yeah,
the metal,
look,
like that big break.
Take a look at this.
It just snapped.
Yeah, this is the rod stand. Yeah. This is the rod.
Yeah, this is the rod stand. Okay. Yep, okay, weighing the second Jahan. About 2.8. Yeah. About 2.8 the Jahan. Yeah, we bled it. That's why there's so much blood. About 2.8 kilo. Alright. Okay, so time now is 12 plus 1. Yeah, we gotta wake up at 6 tomorrow, so we are packing up. Keep all the rods. Pretty satisfied. We managed to get 2 Jahan. 1 3.5 kilo, the other one 2.845 kilo. Yeah, so we bled and filleted both. Honestly, there were 2 other big takes, but one broke off, the other one broke the rod stand. So yeah, it was a pretty high price to pay for this session. Anyway, I certainly didn't expect us to get the Jahan so quickly in one session, just when we decided to come over here, but of course I'm glad we did. I'm glad we didn't spend like 3 or 4 sessions to catch something. So looks like it is in season, I would guess. Yeah, there's been quite a number of catch reports at Bedok Jetty, Labrador Jetty, here and Barrage, if I'm not wrong, something like that. Yeah, so now is the season. If you guys want to go for Jahan, I think now is the time. Our bait was Gelong Sotong. We threw some Apollo, some long snoot bottom feeder and stuff lah. So I think any rig works, as long as they are there, they will probably eat. Yep. So thanks for watching. That's all for this session, and good luck guys.